want to buy for him. Well, I hope Maggie likes her new winter clothes and her buggy with the baby doll. And maybe Tom will smile in his new Nike shoes when he shoots that basketball. I can't help but wish that I could do more, but not just while I'm shopping in the department store. Paper angels, you're in my thoughts and prayers. No matter where you are right now, remember God's right there. He's asking all of us to help take care of his paper angels everywhere.
That's good ball movement. That's good. Boys are moving the ball good today. Oh, I like that, Dookie. That's good.
Dookie's really in the zone today.
I'll let you go get me another beer.
Sure. Smells good. When do we eat?
Soon. So, how's it going in there?
Mustangs are winning, and Dookie's having a great game.
Thomas, I want you to go get Sarah and get in the car.
What?
Shh.
Don't ask any questions. Take Sarah and get in the car right now.
Mom.
Thomas, please.
Where's my beer?
Go.
You lost in there?
Sorry.
What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Bam! Dookie's getting her done today! Now there's somebody I'd be proud to call my son.
Here.
To go, honey.
Listen to me, both of you. We're leaving and we're not coming back. I'll explain when we get there, but
we gotta go.
Where are we going?
Anywhere is better than this.
Pass the ball, spread it out.
You fouled me.
Don't lie, kid. You've been playing dirty all day. Everyone's seen it.
I don't lie, and I don't play dirty. You're not worth it.
Hey! That's enough!
That's enough.
Neutral corners. What did I tell you, Vic?
He started it.
Yeah, well, it's over now. Take a hike.
That goes for the rest of you. Go on. Go on. Show's over.
You okay, son?
Yeah.
Haven't seen you around before. I'm Graham Cody. They call me Pastor Graham.
Thomas Brandt. We just moved here.
That explains it. I'd have recognized you. You're good. You gonna play for the high school team?
Moved around for a while, so I couldn't make tryouts.
That's too bad.
Now, you and Vic on the same team? That'd be something to see.
I don't play dirty.
I know. Word to the wise, though. Vic's used to being the top dog around here. He doesn't like to be shown up.
Thanks.
All right.
You. My office. Come on, Vic.
Sorry I'm late, Kevin. Everyone's trying to get out of the office early for Thanksgiving. I've been in and out of meetings all morning, so...
No problem. Glad you're here.
Yeah. So how's Jenny?
She's good, considering.
When is she due?
February, but the doctor says it's gonna be more like January.
Twin boys, wow.
Tell me about it.
So, are you ready?
Well, is anybody ever really ready? But I think we've been waiting for this for some time, so we'll be just fine. Let's talk over here.
We've known each other a long time, Kevin. And nobody appreciates your company's work more than I do.
We appreciate your business.
You're always on time, you're on budget, and your designs have a unique quality we cannot find anywhere else.
And why do I feel like this is all leading to a but?
But you are also expensive. With the economy the way it is right now, we can't afford to renew Precision Design's contract for next year.
Well, let's put our heads together and figure this out.
And I wish I could.
Dan, you're our biggest client. Without this retainer.
Look, I know this couldn't come at a worse time. Maybe in 6 or 8 months, if things turn around, Kevin, I'm sorry.
How could they all of a sudden just cancel our contract?
I'm sure they didn't make their decision lightly. They've been very happy with our work.
Then I don't understand.
I'm guessing, but it seems obvious. It's the economy, cutbacks.
Kevin, that's like over a third of our operating budget.
Which is why I wanted to talk to you about it right away. I know this is obviously something that affects all of us.
But what happens now?
Well, first of all, let's nobody panic. We have other projects. We have more money coming in before the end of the year. And just this morning, I put out some feelers trying to drum up some more business.
And?
Well, I know with Christmas coming, this is pretty much the worst news I could be telling you. But I also want you to know I plan to do everything I can to keep this company going. Get it while it's hot. Homemade vegetable soup. Perfect thing for a autumn evening.
When did you learn how to make soup?
Well, there's this new thing called the internet. It's amazing what you can find on there.
Well, I'm very impressed. Thank you. But I'm pregnant. I'm not an invalid.
Hey, the doctor says you have to stay off your feet.
I can still make dinner.
Yeah, but I figured I need the practice because once the twins get here, I'll be cooking plenty.
Good point. Thank you, Lord, for this meal. Thank you.
All right.
It's good.
Hey, you hear that, boys? It's good. She said it's good.
Oh, my gosh.
Seriously?
I think they heard you.
No. You kicked, but which one is it?
I don't know.
If this is Mark, kick once. If it's Benjamin, kick twice.
You never told me how that meeting went.
Ah, fine.
How much did they ask you to cut back on the contract?
They decided not to renew our contract. They can't afford me.
What?
We'll be okay.
Are you sure?
Are you kidding? I started Precision Design 10 years ago, and I intend to keep it running until our sons are old enough to support us.
You should have told me.
Look. Well, the only thing that matters right now is that you take care of yourself. I got this, okay?
Okay.
So go back in there, put your feet up. I'll finish up in here. Okay?
Okay. Well, Sarah. Thanksgiving. We got turkey stuffing, cranberry sauce, sweet potato pie, and green beans.
You gotta be kidding.
Wait till you see what we have for dessert.
I don't like green beans.
And no dessert for you, young lady.
I still don't understand why mom has to work today.
They pay time and a half for holidays.
We did a dinner on Thanksgiving.
People with nowhere else to go?
People like us, you mean?
We have a home.
No, we had a home. Now we live here.
Hey, wait. Thank you for this food. Thank you for our family. And please help mom have a good day at work. And be with dad wherever he is. Amen.
Amen.
All right, let's eat. Ooh, we gotta get some ketchup in there, huh?
Hey, Lynn, would you mind locking up? It's just my family's got dinner waiting for me. Sorry.
No problem.
Thanks, and happy Thanksgiving.
You too, Murph. Happy Thanksgiving.
Why'd you say that before? He's not even our dad anymore.
Nothing's gonna change that.
It's been almost a year. He's probably stopped looking for us.
Do you want him to find us?
Do you think he's still as bad?
I don't know, maybe. I just figured the best thing to do is pray for him. Maybe it'll help.
Maybe.
All right, come on. Jump shot, let's see if you can do it.
Okay.
Go for it, ready? All right, make sure you take it all through. Right through like that.
Okay.
Go for it.
Okay.
All right, go for it. There you go. Nice work. Nice work. Nice work. Here, take this just to give you.
Take my card, Bob. In case you change your mind. All right, happy holidays. Thank you.
Don't believe it.
Don't believe it. Wow.
It's been a while. How've you been?
Ah, you know, the usual.
We really miss you at the center.
Yeah, no, I miss it too. It's just been crazy.
Yeah. Jenny's almost due.
A few more weeks, yeah.
Twice blessed. Amen. Listen, I've got to run. It's great seeing you, Kevin. Give my best to Jenny.
I will do.
All right. Hey. I'm serious about missing you down at the center. Why don't you drop by sometime? Show the guy some of those old school moves of yours.
I'll try.
God bless you, Kevin. Merry Christmas.
You too. Thank you.
How are we looking?
Fine.
You always say that.
We are. We're fine. We'll be okay.
You always say that, too.
All right, wise guy. What am I going to say next?
Oh, well, let's see. Next, maybe you'll say, I'm going to open up a little bit, Jenny. Talk about how worried I am. And stop trying to carry the whole load by myself.
You already carry more than your share. I don't want to stress you out even more.
I worry more when you don't talk.
All right, I'm working on some ideas, but everywhere I call, they say wait till after the holidays. Then we'll see.
Sounds so frustrating.
Yeah. There was one bright spot in my day. I ran into Pastor Cody.
From the community center?
Yeah, he wants me to come and play ball with the boys.
Oh, you used to have so much fun when you volunteered over there. Yeah,
like I've got time for that now.
Well, you could make time. You could use a little more fun. Sarah, come on, honey.
The pipes are making that weird noise again.
I'll fix it later. We're gonna be late.
Mom, I gotta get something for lunch.
I made you a sandwich.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, Tommy, I want you to do something for me. I want you to make out a Christmas list.
Yeah, right.
I'm serious. I want you to make me a list of what you want.
Mom, we can barely keep food in the house. Your car's on life support. How are you gonna buy Christmas presents?
I signed you and Sarah up for the Angel Tree program.
The what?
The Salvation Army does a thing where kids make out a Christmas list and then people pick their names and buy the gifts.
Yes, that makes it official. We are now a charity case.
Thomas.
No, I get it, Mom. We're broke. Did you have to advertise it to the whole world?
I just wanted something under the tree for you and Sarah.
What tree? There's not going to be any tree. Dad made sure of that.
This isn't about your father.
It should be. Like, it's his fault we're stuck in this dump. Like, why isn't he doing anything? Why isn't he helping us?
Thomas, it was my decision to leave. If you want to blame anyone, blame me.
It's not what I mean.
I know, honey. And I know this is hard, but it's not going to be forever, okay? Let's just try to have a nice Christmas and be grateful for all the things that we do have. Now, if you won't do it for me, please do it for Sarah.
Anything I want.
Within reason.
So a 16-inch flat-screen TV is out.
Thank you. I love you.
You too.
All right, Sarah, let's go.
Coming.
Thanks, Mom. See you later. Not yet, I gotta go.
Oh, no, they have a deadline. I need to get it in.
Okay, I'll do it today.
Okay, have a good day.
And you too.
Bye, Thomas.
See you, Sarah.
Bye. Mom? Not right now.
Mom, we're not gonna be late,
right? No, we're gonna be fine. We're not gonna be late. No, we're not going to be late.
Smooth ride, Slick.
I can't believe how gross that is. Come on. Start up. Honey, I don't know what's wrong with it.
It's a piece of junk.
Like I planned this, Thomas, just to ruin your life.
Put it in neutral, I'll push. I take the brake off.
Okay, I did.
Hi.
Don't stop.
Thanks.
Anytime.
Wait, what's your...
Graham!
Decided to take you up on your offer.
I'm glad you did.
Yeah, just felt a little drama here. Anything I should know about?
Yeah, it's called getting challenged by the new kid. Really gets the testosterone pumping around here. Man, he's got talent. You ready?
Yeah, let's give it a shot.
Go get him.
Leave this with you.
All right. See what you got.
All right.
follow through. Oh, let me show you. Put your weight here, make sure it's even, follow through the shot. Give it a shot. Boys, you can do this.
What was I thinking?
Here you go.
Oh, thank you. Oh my goodness. Do you realize by the time our sons are that age, I will be oldish.
You're gonna be a great father.
If I can keep up.
Oh, well, take your Tylenol, Grandpa. And warm up next time.
You really think I'm gonna be a great father?
A great father.
It's not automatic, though. I was looking at some of those guys today, and I kept wondering, how do they get so angry? I mean, they didn't start that way. How do you even know if you're doing the right thing?
Our sons are gonna have a safe home, a strong faith, and they're gonna have something that nobody else has. They're gonna have us. Oh, there they are, our boys, Benjamin and Mark.
Look at the hands. Oh, look at the...
They look like you.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They're our boys.
I don't understand.
We talked about how sometimes with twins, one of the babies can be a late bloomer. He just doesn't grow as fast as his sibling.
Last time you said that was normal.
And we'd hoped that the weight discrepancy between baby A and baby B would correct itself with time, but he's just not growing.
Benjamin.
What does that mean?
Well, on one hand, there is a very good chance that both babies are normal and healthy, and this little guy's just smaller.
Or,
with this kind of discrepancy, we're concerned that it could be something more serious.
No. We decided not to. We've waited this long.
I understand, but it could give you some peace of mind.
Is there anything else we can do about it? To help?
You're already doing everything humanly possible. We'll have you come in every week now so we can monitor both babies. And in the meantime, just keep taking care of yourself. Get plenty of rest. We'll see you through this.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay.
Don't get any big ideas, Slick.
What are you talking about?
Cassie. She's way out of your league.
She was just helping me out.
Because she feels sorry for you. Just like everyone else at the school.
I gotta get to class.
Oh, sure. I just didn't want you getting your hopes up about Cassie. See, she's always been a real sucker when it comes to lost dogs, baby birds, and charity cases. Sorry.
No, it's okay. Court's open.
Where's that other guy?
Pastor Graham.
He had to run out. He asked me to lock up. We still got another half.
You passed it here too?
No. Graham ran some camps last summer, so I helped out. Now I'm just messing around. But back in school, I used to play ball to help me clear my head, help me think, you know? I figured I'd give it another shot.
Think about what?
There's always something.
Yeah. I come out here so I don't have to think. Just makes things worse.
Well, not thinking about your problems doesn't make them go away.
So, what do?
I wish I knew.
Maybe we just gotta try our best and have faith things will turn out the way they're meant to.
I know one thing.
What?
We're not leaving here until you miss.
Might be here a while.
Here.
What's this?
My list. One condition. You can't read it.
Thomas.
It's nothing crazy.
Well, then why can't I read it?
Just, okay. Please.
Okay. If someone shows up at our house with a jet ski...
Then you better give him milk and cookies, because it's gonna be Santa.
How you doing today?
I'm good. I think I'm gonna go get some ketchup, though.
Now?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You guys can take my spot.
When the path just don't illuminate and darkness falls on you along the way, every one of us has a guide. Just listen closely to the voice inside. Take my hand, and I will walk next to you. There's a plan, and fate's gonna see you through. Hold on, you won't have to wait.
Hi.
Jenny?
They told me you were up here. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Are you okay? What's wrong?
No, I'm fine. I just wanted to see you.
Well, why didn't you call me? I would have come home. Doctor said you had to take it easy.
That's what I've been doing all week. If I didn't get out of the house, I was gonna go crazy.
Oh, I've been so busy here.
It's okay. Really. You know, I had the strangest dream. I dreamt that you were watching me while I was sleeping, and you looked so worried. All I wanted to do was just hold you and tell you everything's okay.
Just a dream.
You had the same look on your face just a second ago.
I have a lot on my mind, that's all. We both do.
So much so that it's like we put everything else on hold.
That's not true.
Really? You love Christmas. The lights, the music, you look forward to it every year. And now, it's like you don't even want to talk about it.
Every day when I wake up in the morning, I want to think about our future and what we'll be like together. You and I and our sons. And I want to look forward to what's coming. I don't want to be afraid of what might happen.
Yeah, so do I. We'll find a way to do that together.
You know, someone told me recently, maybe all we can do is try our best and have faith that everything will turn out the way it's meant to.
That sounds like good advice.
Mm.
How are you feeling?
I feel good. Well, I might need to sit down a little bit.
Hey, are you hungry? Because if you are, I could go back to the food court and buy probably nothing you could eat.
I'm fine, honey.
All these people.
And there's still weeks to go.
Oh, speaking of which, what do you want for Christmas?
Kevin?
Yeah?
It's a giant angel tree.
The Salvation Army runs a program, and the kids make a list of what they want for Christmas.
And people pick the names and buy whatever they ask for. Yeah, I've heard about this.
It's a great idea.
Let's do it.
What?
Let's pick two names off the tree and buy them whatever they ask for.
Jenny, I don't think we can really afford to.
Okay. You just asked me what I want for Christmas. This is it. This is my gift from you. To make two children very happy on Christmas morning.
You serious?
It'll be good practice. For next year with the boys. After every day after
Thanksgiving sale, okay. Malls just ain't complete. Without a bunch of decorations and a paper angel tree. There's artificial smiles on artificial tree limbs. Saying what she'd love to have and what to buy for him. Well, I hope Maggie likes her new winter clothes and her buggy with the baby doll.
Your pick.
Maybe Tom a smile in his new Nike shoes when he shoots that basketball. I can't help but wish it. Paper angels
I take it you haven't seen it?
Seen what?
Give me your phone.
I must have lost it.
I thought you should know.
What's this?
Vic put it up last night. He's a jerk.
What does that make you?
What?
Be sure to tell your buddy Vic about the funny look on my face when you showed me. I'm sure you two will get a good laugh out of that.
What are you talking about?
Tom Brandt is a new kid at school. As you can see by these pictures, he is in dire need of food, clothing, and a life. If we get 1,000 followers to this page, we will buy Tom a whole new wardrobe. And maybe lunch.
He's not my buddy. I told you he's a jerk. Just another insecure jock that makes himself feel important by bullying other people around.
Fine, whatever.
And just so we're clear, I didn't have anything to do with putting that Facebook page up either. I hate the way those guys were laughing at you.
And just so we're clear,
I'm not some little lost dog. I don't need anybody to feel sorry for me.
What?
So go find another good cause and leave me alone. That's all I want, for everybody just to leave me alone.
The only reason I told you about what Vic was doing is because I wanted you to know that not everyone in the school is like him. Some of us care about each other, but that's okay because you just want to be left alone. So hey, no problem. The next time you think someone's feeling sorry for you, take a good look in the mirror.
Jenny, hey, hi. Everything all right?
You do realize that every time I call now, it sounds like you're at the starting line of a 100-yard dash.
Well, no, come on. I was just, Really?
It's a bad sign when your wife, who's expecting twins, has to remind you to breathe.
Point taken.
But I'm fine. Thank you for asking. I just wanted to tell you that I did all my shopping for Stephanie.
Who?
Stephanie. The little girl I picked from the Angel Tree.
Right, from the mall.
Don't tell me you forgot.
No, I have it right here, the paper angel, yeah.
Kevin, you can't leave this to the last minute like you always do. The Salvation Army needs the presents in plenty of time before Christmas.
Absolutely.
Besides, this might be a good way to get your mind off things.
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you too. Excuse me. Hi. Can I get this in a 10.5, please? And you can just put it on this card.
Kevin?
Amanda!
Oh my gosh,
hi.
I don't believe it!
Wow, it's so great to see you. I thought you were in Nashville.
Visiting the folks for Christmas. Shopping.
That's great. How's the new job?
Oh my gosh, I love it. And the agency's really starting to take off.
Well, I'm sure you had a lot to do with that.
If I have, it's because I learned from my best.
Yeah, we were a pretty good team.
Maybe we can be again.
Tell me more. What?
I was gonna call you. It's not official, but we may have a client here in town signing with the agency. I told everyone in Nashville about you and, well, they want to hear your pitch on the account.
Seriously?
Seriously. Still some hoops to jump through, but with my recommendation, call me right after the holidays. It's great to see you again, Kevin.
It's great to see you.
Merry Christmas.
You too. Merry Christmas. Hey, you'll never guess who I ran into.
Who?
Amanda.
When was the last time you saw her?
I don't know, like a couple years. It came like a bolt out of the blue.
She wants you to call?
Yeah, for the holidays. I mean, the clock's still ticking.
Maybe this is like an early Christmas present.
Yeah, maybe it is. Hey, dinner's on.
Thanks.
Oh.
You're such a gentleman.
Oh, yeah, that's great. Yeah.
Make me an offer?
Oh, no, I was just
I designed this way back when.
You don't say.
My first big contract. At least it seemed pretty big at the time. They liked it. They had it everywhere.
Yeah, I remember.
I'll never forget the first time I walked into a store and saw this. Took everything I had to keep from doing cartwheels down the middle of the aisle.
Well, you should have.
Think so?
How often in life do we honestly appreciate a moment? Pure and simple. Under the circumstances, a cartwheel sounds like just the thing.
Probably right.
You still in the business?
Yeah, though I don't feel very much like doing cartwheels these days.
Yeah. Just when you think you got it all figured out, life comes along, throws you a curve. Just because you get the message doesn't mean you should give up.
What do you mean? What message?
Young fella, I worked my tail off for 40 years trying to get where I thought I wanted to be. Big house, summer home, season tickets to the Titans. One day I went home. Kids were grown. My wife was a stranger. And that big house just seemed empty. My life was like an old puzzle with the pieces scattered all around. I didn't know how to put it back together. Not by myself.
What'd you do?
I got the message. And here we are. Hi, honey.
Hi.
Mwah.
I'll see you at home.
Okay.
Oh, don't forget. Frank and Janet are bringing the kids over for dinner, and then we're having Rachel's recital.
Yes, ma'am. I'll be there. Nancy. Love you.
I love you, too.
You didn't come here to listen to me. What can I do for you?
Actually, I'm here to get a basketball jersey.
All right. Which player? Ah, the paper angel tree.
Oh, you've heard of it.
Here, let's have a look. All right, yeah. Right over here.
Cyberbullying? I don't know. Maybe. Try again. I mean, shouldn't you be talking to somebody about it? Like, maybe a teacher?
What are they gonna do about it? The moment they ask, Vic will delete the page and I'll look like a bigger loser.
Okay. What does your family have to say about it? Right. What did your friend say?
We're talking about high school, remember? Nobody wants to hang out with the new kid, especially when some jock puts a target on his back.
You mean to tell me in that entire high school, no one's reached out to you? A kid as sharp as you.
Maybe I'm not as sharp as you think.
No, maybe you need to reach out to them. Let them know that there's more to you than just being the new kid.
How am I supposed to do that?
Did you ever think that maybe there's something guiding us in everything we do? And I mean when things go wrong, and I mean really, really wrong, there's still a way to get through it. You just have to trust that feeling. Guidance from inside.
Hey, Mom?
Mm-hmm.
When can we get our Christmas tree?
I'm not sure, hon.
My friends already have theirs. They've got lights outside and everything. Like Dad used to put up sometimes.
Yeah, I remember.
We have to get new ornaments and decorations, too. We left all of ours at home. Or we could go back to get them.
Sarah, you know that.
We wouldn't have to stay or anything. We could just get the ones Tommy and I made for you to hang on the tree. maybe Dad's better now. Maybe everything will be okay.
Honey, I miss him sometimes too. But we can't go back.
What if he forgets me?
Come here. No, listen, listen. Your father could never, ever forget you. And every day I pray that he'll get better. He can come show you himself how much you mean to him. But no matter what, I'm going to make sure that everything is good for me and you and Thomas. I promise.
And we can get a Christmas tree?
And we can get a Christmas tree.
What kind of job are you looking for?
I'll do anything. Wash the dishes, mop the floor, clean the parking lot.
I do all that.
But my mom says you're always so busy, so I thought maybe you can use the help.
Yeah, I don't know. Every time I hire a high school kid, he ends up flaking out on me, whether it's a football practice or a big date.
I wouldn't do that.
That's what they all say.
I'm not going to be in school.
What?
I'm dropping out to work.
Does your mother know?
Oh, she does now. Well, quit school.
I was going to tell you.
Thomas.
Not for good, just for a while, just until we get back on our feet.
First of all, you do not drop out of school for any reason. And secondly, well, there is no secondly. You stay in school and that's it.
I'm not a kid anymore, Mom. I can see what's going on around here.
Tommy, everything is under control. I promise.
Just like you promised Sarah we can buy her a Christmas tree.
Is that what's going on here?
No, it's just... I want to do something. It's like something's guiding me, something inside, and I want to trust that and do what feels right.
And I want you to trust that guiding hand inside of you, but not like this, not like dropping out of school.
I want to help you.
Honey, you do help me every day in more ways than you will ever know.
Really?
Yes, really.
Okay.
Don't give up on that feeling. It'll show you the way, the right way. Every time.
Thanks.
Beth Ann?
Kevin! Hey!
Hey!
Getting ready to play Proud Papa, I see?
Not exactly. Doing a little Christmas shopping, and I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing.
The DSV-560 is a good starter camera.
Oh, that's all I needed to hear. Go ahead and ring it up. Huh. Here, you can put it on this card. Well, that's very festive.
Mm-hmm. Every year I take pictures of the children's Christmas pageant at church. I always do it during the dress rehearsal, so I stay out of the way during the actual performance.
Sounds nice.
It is. You should come.
To church?
Yeah, it's tomorrow night at 7, and then we have the service. You know, and bring Jenny. I haven't seen her in forever.
I don't remember the last time I was in church.
Then I'm glad I ran into you.
It's been happening a lot lately.
What?
I'll see you there.
Okay. Bye.
Thank you. Happy holidays.
Jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh.
Facebook page about you.
Don't let that bother you.
It's mean. People shouldn't do stuff like that.
They don't know any better.
Somebody should teach them to know better.
You're a pretty smart kid.
And you're a pretty good brother.
Okay.
You could teach them to know better.
Smiling about?
Not a thing.
You don't get it, do you?
Nobody wants you here. Checked out your little Facebook page lately. You're a joke.
Maybe you should check it out.
What?
Just saying. Just saying.
Want to really feed the hungry? Want to really do something good this Christmas? Get a gift for someone really in need. Not just a student who doesn't have much of a wardrobe. From now until Christmas break, you can bring your donations to my locker 1700. I'll leave it unlocked, and I'll take the gifts to the Salvation Army, and they'll make sure they get to the people who really need them. This isn't about me or you. It's about all of us. How together we can really make a difference. Let's do what is right. Let's do something good as a school.
Daryl.
Hey, Lynn.
How did you find me?
It wasn't easy.
I'm not alone. Murph's in the back.
Hey, I don't want any trouble. I just want to talk.
We're talking.
Can I come in? Please?
What do you want, Daryl?
I wanted to see how you and the kids are doing.
We're fine.
Tom playing ball?
You come all this way to talk about basketball?
No.
How long has it been since you've had a drink?
A little while.
How long?
17 days.
We're not coming back, Daryl.
I didn't come here to ask you that. I wanted to see you. And if maybe I could say hi to the kids.
No, that's not gonna happen.
And I've been doing a lot of thinking, Lynn, about us and about the kids. And it wasn't all bad. I mean, some of it was okay, wasn't it? I'm trying here, like I'm, as God is my witness, I am really trying.
Daryl, you say that all the time and nothing ever changes.
Oh, this is different. Here.
What's that?
Well, I saved up a few months. It's not much, but, you know, it's almost Christmas and...
Is this supposed to make things okay between us?
No. No, it's not. But I want you to know that I'm working on it. I'm working on every minute of every day. If I just knew that you were praying for me, then maybe if I can ride this out and become a better man, I might still have a chance to get my family back. That's it. That's what this is.
Daryl, I am praying for you. We all are.
Thank you.
Like you're out of room. It's a lot of donations.
Hey, yeah, I was... I didn't think so many people would.
I told you not everyone in the school was like Vic.
Yeah, I guess you were right.
Well, here you go.
Cassie, I'm really sorry about the way I acted. I never meant it.
Then why did you do it?
I guess I couldn't figure out why a girl like you would want to be nice to me.
Why wouldn't I? You're a nice guy.
Thanks.
All of this just from this morning?
Yeah, it's crazy.
You're gonna need a lot more space before you take this stuff to the Salvation Army.
Like where?
There's a storage closet down in the basement. Leonard's always up for a good cause. I'll bet he'll let you keep it there for a few days.
Who's Leonard?
He's the head janitor. He's a nice guy. Come on, I'll introduce you.
Hours of music, huh? Sounds good. I'll take it.
Yeah, I'll be back in the office in about an hour. I've got to go over to the Salvation Army to deliver these presents. Today's the last day. Oh, Beth Ann, listen, Jenny's trying to call. I'll see you back at the office. Hi, honey. Aren't you proud of me? I sound so calm. Wait, who is this? I'll be right there.
Kevin.
Oh, where's Jenny?
She's fine. She's resting.
The babies, they're okay?
They're fine, too.
Thank God. What happened?
Well, she'd been out running errands, and when she got home, your neighbor noticed her sitting in the car. When she went to go check, Jenny said she was feeling lightheaded.
But she's okay now, right?
She's tired, a little dehydrated, but you can see her in a minute. I need to talk to you first.
What's wrong? There you go.
Kevin, I'm so sorry. I told them not to bother you. I got a little dizzy, and I didn't...
Hey, it's okay. Honey, listen, it's all right.
What about the boys?
Well, I just spoke to Dr. Chan. He said they're fine.
What else did he say?
Well, he thinks it's a good idea if they keep you in the hospital for a few days.
What?
Well, they just want to make sure you get plenty of rest. And they can monitor the twins at the same time.
But you just said they were fine.
They are. Dr. Chan just feels like it'd be a good idea to... keep an eye on Benjamin. Just to be safe.
Safe?
Yeah, he's showing signs of stress.
Kevin!
He's a fighter, Jenny. Just like his mom. And I'll be right here. We're gonna get through this together.
Okay.
Just a second. Oh, no, that was the... Yeah, second draft of the proposal. That was page 7. Aha, yeah. Right. Okay. Well, thank you very much for considering. Okay, bye-bye.
Channel 6 News, it is so nice to meet you.
Hi.
So, just ignore the camera, pretend it's just like you and I are talking.
Talking about what?
Well, I'd like to interview you, hear more about your Salvation Army project.
Oh, it's not really a project. I just want to try to help some people.
Well, I think that's something that our viewers would love to hear about.
Really?
We're on in 30.
Okay.
You haven't been to the office in 2 days. Is that a good idea right now?
Everything's under control.
Then why all the frantic texting and whispered phone calls that you think I can't hear?
Aren't you supposed to be resting?
You're gonna lose the business, aren't you? I'm so sorry.
We have a lot more important things to think about right now. Why don't you try and get some rest?
Hey, it's the kid from the center I told you about.
I just started here. I didn't really know anybody, but somebody told me, they said there are a lot of nice people at the school, and if I just gave them a chance.
Well, isn't it true that this whole thing started because you were a victim of cyberbullying from another student?
It doesn't matter how it started, as long as things turned out okay.
And you've made sure of that. You've raised hundreds of donations.
It wasn't me, though.
What do you mean?
The way I see it, there's something guiding everything we do, and even when things go wrong, and I mean really wrong, we just gotta trust that guidance. It's like a hand showing us the way.
Sounds like a great kid.
He is.
I heard about their Angel 2 program. It's all about people helping each other without expecting anything back.
Oh, no.
What is it?
Paper Angel, I forgot to deliver the presents.
Kevin.
Well, I was on my way, but then I found out you were here, and I rushed over.
Tomorrow's Christmas Eve.
I know.
You have to take them over there.
Oh, it's pretty late.
Well, it's almost Christmas. With all the gifts they have to give out, I'm sure somebody's working tonight.
I don't want to leave you.
I'm in a hospital. I'm fine. And that boy, he put all his faith in his angel. We can't disappoint him. Not on Christmas.
I'll be right back. Oh, this is gonna be such a cool story to tell our sons.
Go! Go! Go!
Kevin!
Well, Doc, I just need to take care of something.
It'll have to wait.
What? What's going on?
We'd hoped that admitting Jenny would help improve the discrepancy between the two babies, but your son is starting to show signs of additional stress.
What does that mean?
The best choice, our best hope for your son, is to induce labor.
But Jenny's not due for another month.
These things don't always go according to plan. Come on.
It's Thomas.
Yeah. Mrs. Brand?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Captain Chambers. I'm sorry, but we only have the bag here for your daughter.
Oh, there must be some mistake. My son put an angel on the tree. Thomas Brandt. Could you please check again?
We checked. There's nothing here for your son.
I don't understand. How can that be?
Well, unfortunately, sometimes a name doesn't get chosen. But we do have gifts here for our forgotten angels. You're welcome to pick one of those.
Forgotten? How am I going to tell my son that he's forgotten after everything he's been through? Ma'am, I told him that he could still believe in something.
I'm sorry.
It's not your fault. Thank you.
God bless you.
You too.
Got an angel. I hope and pray. Next year the Christmas spirit comes your way. There's a special Christmas tree down at the local mall.
Angel.
Trimmed with paper angels, one and all.
Hey!
What you doing?
I'm just thinking.
You want to come in?
Thomas, your presents didn't come from Angel Tree. I'm sorry.
What about Sarah?
Yeah.
Okay.
How did I get so lucky to have such an amazing kid? I tell you that you don't have any presents and you ask about your sister.
It's okay, Mom.
No. It's not okay. You deserve better than this. You're not some forgotten angel.
What do you mean?
Well, that's what they call someone whose name didn't get picked.
Are there a lot of forgotten angels?
I don't know. Maybe.
I mean,
Salvation Army had more stuff, like toys and clothes and all. And they'd have enough presents for all the Forgotten Angels.
I wanted you to get what you asked for.
It's okay, Mom.
Who's that?
I was gonna tell you about that.
Ready, Thomas?
Cassie. This is my mom. Mom, this is Cassie Bale from school.
Hi, Cassie.
Nice to meet you, Miss Brandt.
So what's going on?
Well, we gotta get everything over to the center. They've got a lot of last-minute requests for gifts.
Oh. What center?
You didn't tell her?
Tell me what?
Thomas collected hundreds of gifts at school to donate to the Salvation Army. They even interviewed him on the news. He's like a hero.
Thomas.
It's no big deal.
He's pretty quiet about it, though. It's part of his charm.
I agree.
Can't we just go already?
Yeah. Nice to meet you, Miss Brandt.
Nice to meet you too, Kathy. Thomas. See you later.
See ya.
Completely, Mr. Morrell. But you can see how busy we are. I can't spare anyone to deliver your gifts.
Then let me take them over myself.
That is out of the question. We protect the privacy of our angels.
Captain Chambers, I know this may sound crazy, but a few weeks ago, I felt like my whole world was falling apart. At work, at home. And then my wife convinced me to pick an angel off of your tree.
Mr. Morrell.
And I got this boy's name, Thomas. But every time I try to buy Thomas a gift, something would happen. Something important to me.
What do you mean?
I'm not talking about winning the lottery. It's more like a feeling. And I'm not explaining this right, but it's as if something or someone was trying to guide me, open my eyes, to show me what really matters in this life.
Mr. Morrell.
Yesterday, I was blessed with the birth of two beautiful, healthy boys. And I know deep in my heart, it's a gift I can never repay. And the closest I'll ever come is to see to it that my paper angel receives the gifts he asked for.
Thomas, I'm so happy.
Dear Tom, I'm sorry these are late. It's a long story, but it has a happy ending, so I hope that it makes it worth the wait. Merry Christmas, and God bless.
Long story. I wonder what that means.
I don't know.
Well, open them.
Wonder what this could be. Merry Christmas.
What?
Merry Christmas, Mom.
Thomas, what are you doing? Honey, these are for you.
You said to ask for whatever I wanted.
You mean it? For real?
For real.
An iPod mini?
Thank you, Thomas. Thank you.
Go ahead, Mom.
Camera. Oh my gosh. I love it. Thank you.
Things haven't been exactly easy around here lately, but we're getting through it, you know? So I thought maybe this could help us all remember that we did it together.
Thank you. There's still two more in there.
Yeah. I know.
What do you think, Dad?
This is gonna be so cool.
Hey, Vic. I got some for you.
Oh, yeah?
I was hoping to get them to you for Christmas. Better late than never, right?
What are you talking about?
Merry Christmas. Receipts in the box. You can exchange them if they're the wrong size.
Well, you think I'm some kind of charity case like those losers at the shelter?
First of all, they're not losers. They just need a little help to get back on their feet. Second, the way I see it, this time next year, you and I are going to be teammates. So I just want to make sure you can keep up with me.
Hey. Thanks.
Merry Christmas.
Hi, Amanda. It's Kevin. Got your voicemail. Sorry I missed your call. Yeah, the project sounds amazing. Thanks for thinking of me. I'm going to be working out of my house for a while. So you have my number. You can call me when you can. Looking forward to working together again. Okay, thanks. Talk to you soon.
Dear Dad, you used to tell me that what makes Dookie Wilson so good is that he never gives up on what he wants. I know what I want now, and I'm never giving up on you. God bless you. Love, Thomas.
kid. Just you and me again.
Looks that way.
Yeah, after Christmas.
Turned out pretty good. Yeah?
Yeah.
How about yours?
It was, really amazing.
Cool.
I saw you on TV.
It's no big deal.
I don't know. Something tells me that you're not the new kid anymore.
I just, did what you said. I trust that feeling on the inside.
It's a good feeling, isn't it?
Yeah.
I was down there too. Salvation Army.
Really? How come?
I picked one of those paper angels off that tree you were telling everybody.